Stephen Daudry, thank you very much for joining us to chat about Trash. This film is shot partly in Portuguese. How is your Portuguese?
Well, my Portuguese is absolutely non-existent.
Oh.
It's a film almost entirely in the Portuguese language. There's a little bit of English, but there's a couple of American characters played by Rooney Mara and Martin Sheen, and they speak both English or American and Portuguese. And the kids have picked up a little bit from video games, but essentially the film is a, but also what's great about it, what's so funny about these foreign language films now, because we've been testing it around the world, and playing it, actually opening it now around the world. And we played it too in the Valley, in Los Angeles. And of course the question from, when we were testing it was, how many people felt that the subtitles were a problem? And of course, even some people in the audience said, is it subtitled? So I think you forget it very quickly.
Right, you do.
I don't think it's one of those films you've got to really work it out.
When you tested it in this country, did you have people come up to you and saying, why isn't it called Garbage?
Do you know, we did not. What a good question. No, we did not have that.
We were having this debate in the office, and somebody was suggesting that a trash is actually a very old English word that's become Americanized.
Right.
But I guess it's universal.
Garbage feels much more contemporary American to me than English. I say rubbish.
Rubbish could work.
Rubbish.
Yes.
I think it's trash because trash is still a play as whether the kids are trash and what's white trash and all that.
Gotcha.
So I think it's a play on who's trash in the first place.
Now, you were a young actor yourself.
I was not.
Were you not? I thought you trained as an actor.
Not really, no.
A little bit, though.
No, as a director, actually, but still, never mind. Good. Sorry about that. Get wrong on that, but no, not really.
That's scandalous.
Scandalous.
I apologise.
Research.
Well, I mean, Wikipedia fed me that nonsense.
There you go.
But it also fed me the fact that that you went to Italy and trained as a clown.
Oh yeah, I did work as a clown,
which is true, and one of the most Fellini-esque things I think I've really ever heard. Have any of those skills come in handy subsequent to that experience?
Well, this is a very complicated answer, but yes, the great thing about as it happens, I can walk the tightrope, and I have worked a lot with elephants. I can juggle and blow fire and do a number of other skills, which I can demonstrate at your Christmas kids' parties, if you like.
Please do.
But the interesting thing is, actually, if you get properly... I was a clown, so if your clown is named, it's a sort of way of discovering an inner version of yourself that actually is quite psycho...
Wow.
I know, quite a sort of deep psychological search in terms of who you are.
You obviously sort of immersed yourself in Brazilian culture, Brazilian lifestyle. What film would you recommend people watch after they see Trash, aside from City of God, which I think Empire readers are probably well-versed in? Is there a Brazilian film from, like, Cinema Nuevo or something that you'd recommend to them that you discovered along the way?
Oh, God, there's so many. What's really interesting about, because one of the reasons we went to Brazil was because my friend Fernando Morales was there and had worked a lot with, the kids in City of God, non-professionals. And so we knew the chances are these kids were going to be non-professionals. And what they did, I thought, was so moving and so brilliant after City of God with those communities where they're taking kids out of. They started drama classes and they started a TV show called City of Men. And the kids just grew up in City of Men. And that became such a successful soap in Brazil, they turned it into a movie, City of Men, the movie, and then went back to doing it as a TV show, really to help the economy of these different communities and actually keep them working.
Yeah.
And we were very, we undoubtedly benefited from that work because we could access the communities. They were very friendly to us. They knew what the idea was. They were very good with O2, this Fernando's company. And we accessed these kids very easily because of that history that they had in Rio, particularly from Fernando Morales.
I was interested because I kept thinking about Elite Squad, the Elite Squad movies, which got progressively more sort of fascistic in the way that they depicted, the favelas and underprivileged sector of that society. And your film is completely coming at it from a completely different direction, and yet you share a cast member in Wagner Mara.
Wagner Mora,
yeah.
Actually, there's a couple of others that we share as well out of interest. I mean, I make lots of jokes about that, but I think you'd have to really know City of God and Elite Squad really well to know how the casting of those two movies informs the casting of this.
Really?
They actually peppered all the way through. And actually, some of the nicest characters in the movie are some of the nastiest kids from City of God. But it's a sort of Brazilian joke for myself, really. But it's obviously this is a film about poverty and corruption in one sense, but it's a film mostly about hope and courage and determination and justice, really, which is... Really, the journey in making the film was trying to, once we'd found these kids, is to get them to tell us the story that made sense for them.
Yeah.
And what's amazing, I think, is that the film is full of hope and humour because of those kids. And we gave them options about, you know, how they wanted the film to develop and what they thought the story should be at the end and where they wanted to all die, be shot by the police, and they all just wanted to get away with it. So that's what we did. But, you know, the real kids all have their own particular traumas of different family members being killed by the military police. And the military police, the corruption within the military police is a well-versed cinematic trope, really, of Brazilian film. I mean, we're not anything new here. But it's certainly for the boys in the film, it was a very personal experience.
The Amazing Adventures of Cavalier and Clay. I just wondered, in this period of cinema where superheroes are so prevalent, does that make you really want to kind of get back and revisit that?
Do you know, it's true. It would be great. The story you're referring to, just for viewers, is a Michael Chabon book called The Amazing Adventures of Cavalier and Clay, which is about the people that really formed these superheroes and first drew them and wrote them and started creating their little graphic novels about them. I hope it will come back to life. It's an amazing book, and who knows? Still stuck in the vaults of Paramount.